Hello there. We are joined now by Tim Oldham, Managing Director and CEO at AdAlta. Tim, good morning to you. How are you doing?
Good morning, Joel. Very well, thank you.
Good, glad to hear it. Listen, I understand we've got full details of the preclinical development of your lead program, AD-214. What can you tell us about it? And what do we know now about what the overarching program looks like?
Yeah, thanks, Joel. We've been working hard over the last 6 months to design the preclinical program to really demonstrate three things about our inhaled version of AD-214. The first one is, can we get it to the far regions of the lungs of a patient, which is where IPF occurs? The second one is, once we get it there, does it actually localize and get retained in the fibrotic lesions or the scarring in those lungs? And then the third thing we're trying to work on is, once we get it there, can it actually moderate or change the course of fibrotic disease? Now, there isn't one single study that we can do that will demonstrate all three of those things, and they're all important to help us understand, you know, what doses to take into the next clinical trials of AD-214. And so we've developed a panel of animal studies and in vitro studies in human lung cell tissues that are going to help us answer those questions. And for the first time, we fully described those this week.
Yeah, as I was just asking a moment ago, how does this change what the broader picture looks like? How significant a move forward is this for you guys?
Yeah, so we've had a lot of questions about, you know, how, what the program looks like for converting our intravenous version of AD-214 into inhaled. And bear in mind that we're doing this for a couple of reasons. One, yeah, we've got a successful phase one study that demonstrated the drug is safe and well tolerated in an IV formulation. That's not maximally convenient for patients, and an inhaled version is much more convenient for them. And we also know, because of the distribution of the IV formulation, that its bioavailability wasn't as great in the lungs as we would have liked. So inhaled delivery direct to the lungs is a much better outcome from a cost of goods perspective, from a dosing level perspective, and a patient convenient perspective. But to do that and to make sure that we know what doses to take into the next studies, we really do need to understand how AD-214 behaves in the lung environment, and to make sure that we can actually deliver it there. And so what we've now done is map out a series of experiments that will read out over the next 4 to 6 months that will answer all of those questions, get us onto all of that information in time to then move into our toxicology studies very early next year, which is on track to then start back in the clinic in the second half of 2023. And so what people are going to now be able to see progressively, you know, is the detail of how we're answering those questions. We've had to do a lot of work around what's the right model, how do we get the imaging stories we want to see, and that's what the team's been working hard on. We had hoped that we would have an initial readout from one study in the first quarter. We weren't able to achieve that. It was a bleomycin mouse model of fibrosis. It's actually a really tricky model to establish. And unfortunately, in this instance, the fibrosis wasn't established in the mouse model as well as we would have liked, so we couldn't get the data we wanted from that study. What the importance of the announcement this week has been is really highlighting that any one study is not critical to this. It's actually the sum total of the results from all of those studies that enable us to move forward. And we're not really critically dependent on any one study anymore.
Yeah, speaking of moving forward, it looks like that's also the case on the IP front. The last time you and I spoke just a month ago, we were discussing a granting of a patent in China. Now you've got one in India, a crucial market presumably for you, not just, of course, for the market itself and the pharmaceutical potential presumably that it has, but also potentially for manufacturing as well. What more can you tell us about this?
So India is a significant pharmaceutical market in its own right. Obviously, with a billion people, its healthcare spend is much lower than other markets, but it is a substantial market. Good to have protection there, and it almost completes now protection of all the major pharmaceutical markets around the world. We just have Europe outstanding right now. But the other significance of India is that it's actually a major market for biosimilars or generic versions of biologics. And so patent protection in India provides us protection of our supply chain as well. It means that not only do we have the opportunity to prevent marketing in the various different markets that we're working in, but as a major source of potential generic competition, we can now stop the manufacturing in India as well.
All right, well, that's where we stand. You mentioned a couple of things coming up for you. What are you looking ahead to more specifically next? And what are the big headlines, do you think, for the next few months?
Yeah, so the most exciting things we're looking for in the near term, we're looking at sheep models of lung distribution. Sheep lungs are very similar to humans. So we're using the sheep to demonstrate that we can get AD-214 into the distant regions of the lungs. And there'll be hopefully some really good imaging showing, confirming the simulations we've already done. We've also got some work coming on human lung tissues that will help demonstrate that once we can get AD-214 into the lungs, that the fibrotic processes can be influenced by AD-214 in that lung tissue. And then finally, probably early in Q3, we'll see the data from the mouse model of lung fibrosis read out as well. So data about distribution and deposition with imaging studies, data about the influence on fibrotic processes in lung tissue, and then finally the lung-delivered efficacy in mice that set us up for toxicology.
Great. All right. Well, we'll look forward to hearing more about it and checking in with you next time we speak.
Great. Thanks, Joel. Look forward to it.
Thanks, Tim.